In this video, we'll discuss how to solve first order partial differential equation and some basic concepts about partial differential equations. So we know that in ordinary differential equation, there is only one independent variable, but in partial differential equation, there is at least two independent variables can be moved. The dependent variables can be one, can be moved. There is no restriction for the dependent variables. So the general form of partial differential equation can be written as a function of dependent and independent variables and derivative of dependent variables is equals to zero, means the equation is homogeneous. Normally we put function of independent variable in the right hand side. If the function of independent variable are not zero, that means the equation is non-homogeneous. So how to identify the equation is linear or non-linear? For the non-linear equations, we also know about the ordinary differential equations. The same condition will be applied in partial differential equations. We have to check the power of dependent variables and its derivative must be 1. The coefficients of dependent variables and its derivative must be constant or function of independent variables. If any PDE does not hold these two constants, that is called nonlinear PDE. If the differential equations or PDE exist these two conditions, is called linear partial differential equations. So there are another properties which is very important to solve partial differential equations, that is called superposition principle. We know that if u1, u2, u3 up to un are the solution of a differential equation, then we can write this solution as a linear combination such as u equal to c1, u1, c2, u2, c3, u3, c and un, also the solution of the given differential equation. So this concept is called the superposition principle. That means the superposition principle is combining two or more solution in linear combinations. So when we solve partial differential equations, we will get the boundary conditions. So Dirichlet boundary condition means the boundary condition given without derivatives. Just for u0 equal to alpha, ul equal to beta, if the length of the rod is given 0 to L. Similarly, Newman boundary conditions, in this case, the boundary condition will be given in terms of derivative, like ux0t equal to alpha, uxlt equal to beta. Here the length of the rod is 0 to L, that means x is greater than 0, less than L. Mixed boundary condition, in this case, the boundary condition will be given in terms of 1 will be given in terms of u, that means dependent variables, another one will be given in terms of derivatives. Now we'll discuss how to classify partial differential equations. Let us consider a second order partial differential equations, a del square u del x square plus b del square u del x del y plus c del square u del y square plus d del u del x e del u del y plus f u equal to z. So you have to make sure that all the derivatives and dependent variable must be in the left side, and without dependent variable, that means the function of independent variable must be in the right side. If z is 0, it is called homogeneous. That means the function of independent variable at 0 is called homogeneous. The function of independent variable at not 0 is called non-homogeneous. So to classify the partial differential equation, we have to consider b square minus 4ac. That means in this case, we can use only quadratic term like del square u del x square, the coefficients a, del square u del x del y b, del square u del y square c. We only use these three conditions. If the equation is more than second order, third order, fourth order, we also use only these three terms to classify the equation. So the discriminant b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, in that case we can say the equation is hyperbolic. B square minus 4ac equals to 0, we say the equation is parabolic. And b square minus 4ac less than 0, we say the equation is elliptic. Let us consider an example. This is a third order partial differential equations. You can see here, cos y is the only function with only independent variable. There is no dependent variable. So this term is supposed to be in the right side. That means z is not 0. The dependent variable is u here. Independent variables are x and y. So cos y is the function of independent variables. So we can say that this equation is non-homogeneous. So when we compare with the second order differential equation, here we get I equals to 0, b equals to also 0, c equals to 1. So b square minus 4ac equals to 0, that means we can say that this equation represents a parabolic equation. We also classify partial differential equation based on eigenvalues. When the eigenvalues have the same sign, in that case we can say this is elliptic equation, example Laplace equation. When eigenvalues is 0, that means one eigenvalues is 0, in this case we can say this equation is parabolic, like heat equation, diffusion equation. When we see that one eigenvalue has opposite sign, that is called hyperbolic equation, example wave equation. Here I give you another example. Classify the following partial differential equation as hyperbolic, parabolic and elliptic. In this case we use this one, and that means we use discriminant. So here we can see that our a equal to 1, b equal to 3, c equal to 4. We no need to use this. So in this case we get b square minus 4ac equals to minus 7, that means it's less than 0. We can say that this is a elliptic equation. So we can see here in this equation the function of independent variable, that is 2x minus 3y, that means z is not 0. So this is a non-homogeneous equation. To solve partial differential equation we use this formula. We already know this formula from our ordinary differential equations. Let us consider an example to solve. So this is a first order partial differential equations. This is a homogeneous equation. So we have to remember that we always use product solution to solve partial differential equations using separation of variable methods. If the question don't mention, just say solve, you have to use also product solution using separation of variable. In this case, we can see that our dependent variable is u and independent variable are x and y. So that's why we consider u is the function of x and y. So if we choose a product solution x, here capital X function of x, capital Y function of y. Then when you find the first derivative, del u del x, we can say x prime y, del u del y equals to x y prime. So when we put this del u del x, del u del y in the given equation, then we get this equation. Now we have to separate x in one side, y is another side. So after simplification we get x prime by x equals to y prime by y. So to solve this equation we consider lambdas. Here lambda is a arbitrary constant, that means we can say lambda is eigenvalues. So this constant can be 0, can be less than 0, can be greater than 0. So for the first order PDE, we solve this problem into two cases. One case is lambda equal to 0 and the case lambda is not 0. That means in this case lambda can be alpha square, lambda can be negative alpha square. That means in this case lambda can be greater than 0, lambda can be less than 0. So we combine these two cases. Since our PD is first order, so when lambda equal to 0, we put lambda equal to 0 here, then we get x prime equal to 0. So when we solve x prime equal to 0, we get x equal to c1. Similarly, when we put lambda equal to 0, we get y prime equal to c2. Y prime equal to 0, that means when we solve y prime equal to 0, we get y equal to c2. In this case, we know that u equal to x and y, so we put the value for x is c1, y is c2. That means c1 and c2 are arbitrary constants, so we can consider the product of c1 so c2 also an arbitrary constant, that is a. So this is the solution for lambda equal to 0. Now we consider lambda equals to plus minus alpha square, that means lambda is not 0. In this case lambda can be greater than 0, can be less than 0. So when we put lambda equal to plus minus alpha square in our given equation, this equation x prime minus lambda x by x equals to 0, y prime minus lambda y times capital Y equal to 0. Here capital Y is the function of Y, capital X is the function of X. So we get this relation. When we simplify, we can get x prime by x equals to plus minus alpha square by x, and y prime by y equals to plus minus alpha square y. So in this case, even we can write only lambda here, no need to write alpha squared. So here, when I simplify this equation by cross multiplication, we get this equation here. We can use even only lambda. So now we will solve these two equations, x prime by x equals to plus minus alpha square by x, that means we can write only lambda by x, y prime y equal to plus minus alpha square by y, or we can write only lambda by y. This one you also can write only lambda by x. So when we integrate this one, in the left hand side we get ln x, in the right hand side we get plus minus alpha square ln x plus c1. C1 is the integrating constant. Similarly, from this equation, when we integrate both sides, we get ln y equal to plus minus alpha square ln y plus c2. Here c2 is the integrating constant. So when we use this formula, e power ln x is equal to x, so we get x equals to a1 e power plus minus alpha square ln x. Here a1 means e power, here a1 means e power c1. Similarly, from this equation, when we apply this formula, we get y equal to a2 e power plus minus alpha square ln y. Here a2 means e power c2. Now x equals to a1 e power ln x. We can write in the ln, this one we can put as a power. Similarly here, this one we can put as a power of 1. So now we get x equal to a1 x, because we know that e power ln x equals to x, so here x equal to this whole thing is x. We again apply this formula. Similarly here we again use this formula, so e power ln x, here x means the whole things, y power plus minus alpha square. So u equal to xy, we put x equal to a1 this, that means here we get u equals to a1 x power plus minus alpha square and y equal to at 2 y power plus minus alpha square. That means we get a 1 at 2 xy power lambda. So since a 1 and a 2 are arbitrary constants, so in this case we can write this is equal to a, so xy power lambda. So this is our obtained answer. Let us consider another example, that del u del x plus 3 del u del y equal to 0. So same as before, we consider u x y equals to capital X x. Here capital X is the function of small x, capital Y is the function of small y. So we get del u del x equal to x prime y, del u del y equal to x y prime. Now we put all these things in the given equation, so we get x prime y plus 3 x y prime equal to 0. So we rewrite the equation x prime y equal to minus 3 x y prime. Now we bring all x one side and y another side. That means when we divide this equation by x y, then we get x prime by x, here we get y prime by y times minus 3. So we consider this is equal to lambda. So again, lambda here can be 0, can be greater than 0, can be less than 0. So if we solve this problem into two cases, lambda equal to 0, in this case we get this equation equals to x prime equal to 0, and this equation give us y prime equal to 0. Again we get x equal to c1, y prime, from y prime equal to 0 we get y equal to c2. That means our solution u equal to c1 c2. That means c1 c2 are arbitrary constants, that's why I consider a, the product of c1 c2 is also another arbitrary constant, that is a. So this is the answer for lambda equal to 0. Now we consider case 2. In this case lambda is not 0, lambda can be greater than 0, lambda can be less than 0. So x prime minus lambda x equals to 0. This equation give us solution x equals to c1 e power lambda x, because we know this formula y prime plus alpha y equal to 0. In this case y equal to c1 e power minus alpha x. So here we replace this alpha by minus lambda, then we get x equals to c1 e power lambda x. Similarly, from this equation here our alpha equal to lambda by 3, then y equal to c2 e power minus lambda by 3y. Here independent variable is y, here independent variable is x. So now finally we get u equal to x times y, that means c1 e power lambda x times c2 e power minus lambda by 3y. That means we get c1 c2 e power x minus 1 by 3y, we take common lambda. Finally we write c1 c2 equal to b, since c1 and c2 are both arbitrary constants, so the product also be arbitrary constant, that is we consider b. So here e power, we take common lambda by 3, then we get 3x minus y. So this is our obtained answer. Let us consider another example here. Say ux plus uy equal to u. So same as before, we consider u equal to xy, then we get ux equals to x prime y, uy equal to xy prime. So we put this ux and ui in the given equation, then we get x prime y equals to x y minus y prime, that is so here I show you how to get this relation from the given equation. We put ux equals to x prime y and u equal to xy, uy equals to x y prime. When we take common x, then we get y minus y prime times x. Now we rewrite this equation in this form, That means we divide this equation by xy, then we get x prime by x, y minus y prime by y. So now we separate this equation, x is one side, y is another side. That means we use separation of variable. So to solve this equation, we consider these two relation is equal to lambda. Lambda is arbitrary parameter here. We can say lambda can be 0, lambda can be greater than 0, lambda can be less than 0. So now we simplify this relation, x prime plus minus lambda x equals to 0. Similarly, y minus y prime equals to lambda y. When we simplify this equation, then we get this relation. That means y prime plus lambda y minus y equal to 0. So when we simplify this equation, we get this relation. Now we get two equation. One is for capital X, another one is for capital Y. So now we can solve these two equation to get X and Y. So for case one, lambda equal to 0, when we put lambda equal to 0, we get x prime equal to 0. So when we integrate this equation, we get x equal to c1. Similarly, when we put lambda equal to 0 here, then we get y prime minus y equal to 0. So in this case, we use this formula because we know the formula as y prime plus alpha y prime plus alpha y equal to 0. In this case, the solution y equal to c1 e to the power alpha x. So in this case, y is the function of x. That means y is dependent variable, x is independent variable. In our case, capital X is the dependent variable, small x is independent variable. So in this case, we can write the solution here. That means in this case, our alpha equals to minus 1. So we can write the solution y is the function of small y, c2 e power alpha minus alpha x. Since alpha is minus 1, so minus minus plus, so only y. Now we get the solution as u equal to capital X and capital Y. Here we put x equals to c1, x equals to c1, and y equal to c2 e power y. So c1 and c2 both arbitrary constants, so we consider the product of c1 and c2 is a, so we get the solution a e power y. In this case, our a equal to c1, c2. Now we solve these two equations for case 2. In this case, case 2, lambda is not equal to 0. That means lambda can be greater than 0, lambda can be less than 0. So when we put lambda in this equation, in this case, our lambda is not 0. So x prime minus lambda x equals to 0. So we get the solution u equal to this. So now we solve these two equations for lambda is not equal to 0. In this case, lambda can be greater than 0, can be less than 0, but lambda is not 0. So this equation become like this. So when we compare with our given formula, this formula, this is the formula. when we compare with this formula, in this case our alpha means minus lambda. So we can write the solution for this equation C1 e power minus alpha means minus minus lambda, that means e power lambda x. Similarly here alpha means lambda minus 1, so we can write the solution C2 e power minus alpha, alpha means lambda minus 1 y. When we simplify this one, it is become 1 minus lambda, so y equal to C2 e power 1 minus lambda y. Now we can write the solution as u equals to x y, that means our x equals to c1 e power lambda x, our y equal to c2 e power 1 minus lambda y. So here c1 c2 are arbitrary constants, so we consider product of c1 c2 is a, then e power lambda plus 1 minus lambda y. That means in this case we can get e power lambda x plus y minus lambda y. When we simplify this one, we get like this. So this is our obtained solution.